Hey everyone, Dr. Neil Oza here from Ocean Point Dental Assisting Academies. And I'm here today with some really exciting news. We have decided to extend our registration to December 5th. So that means y'all still have time to register for our courses. It's a 10-week program and spots are filling up pretty quickly. So give us a buzz at 985-551-0329 to learn more about our course.
The basics. You've all heard of Tangi Tourism, right? Tangipahoa Parish Convention and Visitors Bureau, the Tangipahoa Parish Tourist Commission. These become tongue twisters, so a lot of times we just go by Tangi Tourism. It's a lot easier, especially at home, when you actually know where Tangipahoa Parish is. So something I realized today when getting ready for this is that our office has been open for 40 years. We're celebrating an anniversary, a big one, another 10 years. But Miss Betty Stewart, which many of you know, she was the Grand Marshal for the festival quite a few years ago. She and Doc Gideon worked together and created a board, and they were able to open our tourist commission. The idea was in 79, but it opened in 1982. Carla Tate has been our director since 2014. Golly, the time flies. But one of the most important things to note is that we're run a little bit different. We are a partner with Tangipahoa Parish government. We're not under the umbrella of Tangipahoa Parish government. We're a semi-governmental entity that's created by a division of the state. So our rules are a little bit different than everybody else's. We're all kind of on our little own little universe, but it's great because it gives us the opportunity to really partner and branch out and expand our services. We are funded from actual lodging tax. Everybody goes on vacation in this room, I'm sure. Y'all have stayed in a hotel, campground, bed and breakfast. Then in Tangipahoa Parish, it differs from wherever you're gonna go throughout the United States. It can be as high as 8% in New York City to 2% in a little bitty town that only has cabins. But that 4% lodging tax that our visitors that are coming to town pay, that's our budget. That's how we pay salaries. That's how we have our beautiful visitor center on Ward Line Road. If you haven't visited it, make sure you do that. That's how we do our advertising. Which also leads into another question that's commonly asked is, well, we don't see a lot of your logo, your ads in Tangipahoa Parish. Well, it goes back to our mission. Heads in beds. If we don't fill the hotels, campgrounds, and bed and breakfast, we don't get paid. It's that simple. Then we can't support the other organizations like the Tula Q, like the Strawberry Festival, like the Amy Oyster Festival, all the things that really do bring in outside visitors to our office. So heads in beds. We are governed, because we are our own entity, we're governed by a board of directors of 8 people. And those are decided by the parish council. So we have, I think it's 10 councilmen and only 8 board of directors, so they work together, and sometimes you'll see things, so it's not like we have one Manchac, one Ponchatoula, one Hammond. They kind of cross the line. So for your area, for Ponchatoula, we have Brayville LeBlanc. Everybody knows Brayville. So he is your representative on the board, and then 2 of our board members must be a hotelier and a campground owner. And that is to make sure that when we are really focusing our marketing efforts, because everybody knows everything's changed in the last 2 years, that we have their guidance and they're the voice of our lodging association, or those 2 members that are on our board. You know, just getting back to the normalcy, we had to be closed for quite a few times, and none of us like that. We're people people. You're here because you're people people. We're social. We like to interact with folks. Having our doors back open was just because we opened for like a month and then Ida hit and we had to close for safety reasons. Is just bringing new life back into our facility. So if you've got folks in town, be sure to stop by. We're the place that tries our hardest to have the most up-to-date information that you could possibly do. So, you know, we talked about like heads and beds. That's our bread and butter. That's what our main mission and goal is. I'm not gonna read you the mission statement. That's this long. But I think the coolest part of our jobs is that it's different. Like, there's no one set thing. So when we compare ourselves to some of the other bureaus throughout the United States and the world in general, we're not dependent strictly on convention business and meetings, not just group travel, not just amateur and collegiate sports, not just festivals, not just leisure traffic. So when things happen, like emergencies, hurricanes, random pandemics that nobody in the world could have thought would ever happen to us, we don't get that big punch like a lot of the other cities do because we are so diversified. And that's, I think, one of our favorite things about our hometown, our parish, and our jobs. So one of the things that's been really hot lately and definitely coming back is the movie industry. People think of just like They're here, but they're spending money. They're spending money in ways that nobody can ever possibly see, different than tourists do. The lumber companies will get bought out. Our antique shops, they love them. And sometimes they'll buy them, the items, use them for the movie, and donate it back or donate it to one of the thrift stores in the area. So they use the dry cleaners, they use the ice machines, anything that you can possibly imagine. And it goes back to those partnerships with the fire department because they need water, parish government because they need roads and bridges closed at some point. So actually, anybody know we have a movie filming right now? Yeah, it's out at Rosaryville. Nobody knows it's there. They're going to be there for a month. So while they're here, they've already been prepping, building sets, and they should be, if all goes well, wrapped up in about a month. But you don't even notice them because they blend in just like the community. So if you hear somebody with a little accent, normally they have a lot of gear, backpacks and cameras and things like that, and they're just eating in our restaurants. You don't even know. They just picked up their dry cleaners. They gassed up their car. So we like that. So that one is going to be filming. It's called Nickel Boys out at Rosaryville, which is quickly becoming a hot spot for filming. But we had Daisy Jones and the Six. That's about Fleetwood Mac. That was earlier this year at Southeastern, mostly on campus at Southeastern. Rebel Ridge. This is one of those that started and stopped 15 times since 2020, but we finally got him out of here. That's one, another one that was on the back roads of Ameet and Independence, LaRanja, Little Bend, downtown Hammond. But they did a project with Grace Memorial Church and were able to do, instead of a rental fee, a donation that helped their congregation. Palmer was filmed a couple of years ago at one of our local Ponchatoula schools, and they were able to do improvements at the school and do that donation. So a lot of times we thank the school board, we thank the superintendent to working with us on those kind of projects. And everybody remembers A Christmas Wish, right? Our Lifetime movie. Well, we're still on the radar with Daniel Lewis, was the great director for that project, and we almost landed another one this year, but it was contractual thing. So he promises he's going to bring us a Hallmark movie back as well. That's good, clean, new money into our community, so we hope you'll be patient with road closures as well. Sports are huge in Tangipo Parish, and we had bets in our office. What's the first thing coming back? Is it leisure traffic? Is it groups? Is it sports? Nobody thought groups were going to come back for quite a while, but they did. Sports, amateur sports, Southeastern-related sports, anything out at Chappapee, Lepard, J.R. Teague's studio, and also Oak Knoll. Oak Knoll was one of the busiest places in all of Tangipahoa Parish during the pandemic, and still, so they got noticed with that there's new investment. If you haven't been out to Oak Knoll, go check it out. They've done incredible improvements out there. Covey Rise. Everybody's been to Covey Rise, right? No? All right, who hasn't been to Covey Rise? What? Do you know what Covey Rise is? It is this incredible hunting lodge that people come from all over the world to go out and either shoot the sporting clays or different types of birds. But they have the most incredible wedding venue there now, an event venue. I think the school board just met out there not too long ago at their conference center. I had no idea there were purple bell peppers until we were out there the other day. And they do. They ship to most of the most exclusive restaurants in New Orleans and Baton Rouge in this entire region. So when you're in a restaurant, make sure and notice if it says Covey Rise Vegetables. And if you get a chance, go take a tour out at that facility. I mean, you can plan any type of event. It's absolutely incredible. So with the changes and the evolution of having to shift things around because we are rural, we were able to take on, I believe for the first time, the Louisiana Sporting Clay Association's state tournament. That turned into hosting, we were supposed to in September of 21. We were going to host a 2,000-person attendee South Central Regional where people were coming from Peru and Brazil. The Olympian, the representative of the United States, well, we all know what kind of happened in August, September. So they gave it to us for 2023. So we're going to have all these people here coming in with their ATVs, and these people don't stay for just one day, and they don't just stay at Covey Rise. They are all over the place. I mean, there's only so much lodging there, so they're going to be in the Hammond, Ameet hotels. They like Airbnbs. They like traditional bed and breakfast. Some will be at the campgrounds for 7 days. That is a huge, with their families. It's a huge economic impact. And just another example of how we are so diversified, and that's what makes Tangipahoa Parish successful. So some of the other things, we have really cool jobs, Dana. The South Pole Cattle Association, it's a specific type of breed of cattle that are small, so they eat less grass, and they do well with the humidity. out in a farm in Roseland. We had almost 1,000 people in Roseland on a farm out there. They had to bring in all the catering and all the tables and all the chairs and tents out to that farm. And that was in June. Y'all remember how hot it was in June? We're Southern, they're not. But everybody was happy and loved the hospitality. Some of the other things that Faith and I have specifically been working on is the group travel market. You're going to see more and more and more of this. And this is where the hospitality of our community shines. Because I think we have the best downtowns in the entire United States. They're cool, they're hip, they're diversified. They have, antiques, uniques, and boutiques, and all the restaurants that you can eat. But bus groups have the opportunity to go anywhere. So fortunately, right before the pandemic, and then one of the things that we had this past year were group travel trade shows. And when you can host them in your area, priceless, absolutely priceless. So we rolled out the red carpet for one of the groups. We painted a strawberry for another group that was in town. It was hot, so we did straw hats, which they wore for the rest of the week in Louisiana with their big strawberries on their straw hats. And we have been chosen the week after these familiarization tours, we call them. That's when we bring the tour planners in, and they see how special our community is. The phone is ringing off the hook. We have groups coming from Michigan, from Vermont, a lot from Texas, from Tennessee, Kentucky, all over the place. And it's because we had the opportunity to showcase them what we do. Because it's when y'all see them on the street, and we're carrying around 30 people, you wave at them, you say hello. I can't tell you, that's not something we can teach. Our parents apparently taught us that. That is the reason they're coming here. So when you see us with big motor coaches and we might be moving a little slow, just have a little patience. Because these folks, the one group, I think they bought out Expressions Boutique. You know, so our partnership with the DDD, with the city, with the chamber, with all the local merchants is just invaluable. And you're gonna see a whole lot more of that. Coming up in the near future. Just an incredible amount of activity happening right now. We continue to host. I'll have somebody in town this weekend. She's from New York City, American Tour Guide Company, and she had a convention in New Orleans. She was close enough, kept hearing through the grapevine because word travels, you know that, how wonderful this area is and how accessible it is to New Orleans, the Gulf Coast, Baton Rouge. So we'll be hosting her and taking her because she plans luxury trips, 12 to 25 people that want to spend a lot of money at upscale establishments. So we just got lucky that we're going to roll in about 3 o'clock at the end of trade days to show them how cute. I mean, the community looks incredible when trade days is here. So we'll be touring them around for a couple of days as well. We're going to Global Wildlife. We're going to showcase a little bit of the quilt trail. Revival Art House. Everybody's been to Revival Art House. If you have not, put that top on your list to do. We may go to Tower Tracks, definitely go shopping. I don't think we have any baseball tournaments this time of year, but we could definitely check that out. We've had a lot of new businesses that were created during this time, surprisingly. And I think it is because we are that rural attraction where people felt a little bit more comfortable. Have y'all done the axe throwing at Louisiana Axes or Old Town? Have y'all done that yet? It's super duper fun. You definitely got to check that out. And then like Mandy May has her studio downtown, Revival Art House. Twin Steeples is one of the greatest assets that we're going to have in our community. Little throwback to the Louisiana Strawberry Preserve Society. We're actually going to host an entire month exhibit at Twin Steeples, and we're collecting artifacts and memorabilia. So if you've got anything that you'd like to, just let us borrow. You know, we're going to tag everything, make sure you get it back. That'll be the entire month of March. So you can imagine we're trying to get a lot of bus groups in to see that as well. There's also the Old Town Hatchet in downtown Hammond that just opened up, the Escape Warehouse. I mean, all these things just came on board. Florida Lee Tea Room, y'all, we are the only commercial nursery for tea in Louisiana, the only. And it was started right up there outside of Amy. It's in that same area as Covey Rise, Bienvenue Mon Ami. If you haven't checked it out, look them up on Facebook. Florida Lee Tea Company. And you know, so it goes on and on. Norley Barley's expansion, they're one of the top 50 brewers in the entire United States. How different does our Tangipahoa Parish look than it did when we were all growing up? It's amazing. The growth at Southeastern University alone, I mean, when I was there, I think it was like 8,000 students. Now there's 15,000. So it's, you never know. And I think that's the funnest part about tourism. We have no idea what we're going to be involved with most of the time. Sometimes it's hosting a meeting in our conference room for nonprofit organizations during the week. That's service that we're able to provide for the community for free. More than anything, you know, it's if you just want to chat. If you've got something that's interesting to tell us about that we may not know about, we try to be everywhere, but we can't be. Let us know. And it's at 13143 Wardline Road over in Hammond. And if you're getting on the interstate off 55, turn right to go to the university, turn left, we're right at the bottom of the overpass right there.
Travel back in time to experience the Middle Ages at the Louisiana Renaissance Festival. Explore the English village of Albright at the height of the 16th century and enjoy jousting tournaments, dueling, juggling, magic, and falconry. Meet the Queen. Experience the charms of musical minstrels. See real blacksmiths, glass blowers, candle makers, and so much more. And shop for fantastic and unique items you can't find anywhere else. The Louisiana Renaissance Festival,